Patrick Jansen has asked how to green stuff cloaks. So in today's video, we're going to show you how to do that. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is get some tools together. And as you can see here, I've got some green stuff. I've also got a knife to cut out the green stuff. I'm going to use the texture tool just to help move that green stuff around when I'm actually trying to mould the cloak design. I'll also need a model to actually put the cloak onto. So I've got a nice Astromilitarum Catachan Jungle Fighter built there. And I've also got a pot of water so I can keep my fingers nice and moist when I'm using the green stuff. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut that green stuff out. So I'm just going to take my lid off the knife, and all I'm going to do is just cut equal amounts, just a nice broad snippet there of the green stuff and the blue stuff. So just make a little indentation like so, and then just cut in with your knife. I also like to remove the middle bits as well, just because sometimes they've kind of touched, the two parts touching each other actually start to cure. So what you want to do is just cut those out, because sometimes you can get some little knobbly bits inside. Especially if you're doing cloaks, you don't want that. You don't want a big dry bit in the middle of your cloak. You want it to look nice and smooth. So with that done, what we're going to do now is just get those two parts. And then what I like to do is I often just start off just by twisting it. That just helps the two parts mix. And then I just put it in the palm of my hand and then just roll it around into a ball until it goes a nice green. And you're looking for somewhere between Warboss green and Scarsnik green. Do that a little bit more, and we'll just start rolling in the palm of my hand. With the green stuff now mixed, what we're going to do now is just going to start pressing it down and form a rectangular shape, like so. I'm just going to get my fingers nice and wet because it can get quite tacky at this point, on both sides there. And all I'm going to do is firmly hold probably more than one half of it, and then just stretch the material like so. Now, I'm just going to tear that a little bit off there. So this is going to form the basis of our tatty cloak. So what I'm going to do is, there's a lot of material here, so I'm just going to rip a little bit off the top like so. And this is now the start of our cloak. So what I'm going to do is grab my Catachan Jungle Fighter, and I place this on top like that. And then this extra material on the top here, I'm just going to start forming around his neck. So it almost like forms like part of the cloak going around him. Now the great thing of Astromilitarum is they've actually got little clasps, so you can just attach it there and then rip any excess off after. All I'm going to do is just ever so slightly fold that side over, like so. With that first part of the cloak now attached, what I'm going to do is do something very similar to what we've just done. So I'm going to get my green stuff, and then I'm going to just tear it ever so slightly. I'm going to pick this side, actually, because that looks a bit better. So that's going to form the next part of our fold. Just take a little bit off the top. Now I can feel it sticking to my finger, so I'm just going to add a little bit of water there, so it just makes it easier to work with. Like so. That's a great thing about water. So at this point, I might, you could, depend on the size of the model, just attach it like so. But what I'm going to actually do with this is just fold it over, and it will give me a little bit of a fold going down. And all I'm then going to do is just attach that like so to the side, and that's going to form the last part of my cloak like so. And again, I'm just going to move this into that green stuff at the top like so. Just keep pressing down. What we've got, the makings of our Astromilitarum tatty camo cloak. So you can see you've got all this tattiness here at the very bottom. Now what you can do when it's dry, if you don't want it to look too tatty or battle worn, is actually just get some scissors and then just snip at it. Give it, you'll have to wait for it to dry to do that, but actually that'll give it a nice effect. Now before you start painting this, I'd recommend giving it a good 24 hours to fully dry before you do any painting on it as well. Well, I hope you found that useful, Patrick. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.